Hi there, we are Collabro.
Do you have day jobs?
I'm a labourer.
I'm a sales assistant on a petrol garage.
I'm a kitchen salesman.
I work in a Japanese restaurant.
I work in a hospital.
Okay, lovely. How long have you guys been a group?
We've been together for about a month now.
A month? Oh, not long. What makes you think after a month that you're good enough to win Britain's Got Talent?
Natural chemistry, I think.
Okay, lovely. Well, whenever you're ready.
There, out in the darkness, a fugitive running, fallen from God.
Didn't expect this.
Fallen from grace, God be my witness, I never shall yield, till we come face to face, till we come face to face. He knows his way in the dark. Mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, aflame the sword. Stars in your multitude, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky. You hold your course and your reign, and each of your seasons returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall.
I may see him
safe behind bars, 'cause I will never rest till then. This I swear I
reduced me to tears. I just could burst with pride for you because that was bloody brilliant. Absolutely.
You know what? When the five of you came out, I thought, here we go again, another boy band. This is going to be awful. It was an absolutely brilliant audition.
Brilliant.
It was a faultless performance, guys. It was absolutely fantastic.
Oh, what a great song.
Yeah, I know. It's not an obvious choice of song as well, which is great because we hear the same songs over and over again. I really think this could be very big.
You've achieved that in a month. That's astonishing. That is definitely by far one of the strongest auditions I've ever seen.
Thank you.
guys.
Amanda?
Oh, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. David?
Yes!
Alicia?
It's a yes from me, guys.
Thank you.
You know what? Britain really has got talent.
Till I dream he comes to me.
It's four yeses.
Now, it all comes down to just two, Lucy Kay and Collabro. One of you will leave here tonight with £250,000 and a place on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2014 is...
Congratulations,
Lucy, second place, runner-up. How do you feel?
Amazing. It's just been completely... I felt speechless, and I knew they would win from the start. You know, I should have put a bet on it. And to the guy who put £1,000 on bet on me winning, I'm so sorry.
You've been amazing. We're so thrilled you came down and auditioned for us. One more time, our runner-up, 2014, Lucy Kay, everybody!
Winners of Britain's Got Talent 2014. How do you feel, Jamie? Oh, I picked somebody else, guys.
We'd like to just thank everybody that's voted. You're absolutely amazing. Judges, thank you so much. And to Lucy as well. She's absolutely incredible. Oh, and all the apps. Just
thank you, collaborators. Yeah. We love you.
Let's start with hello.
Hello. I am Viggo, I'm from Norway, but I live in the UK now.
Good.
Norway is very boring.
And what's your last name?
Venn. Yeah, like the diagram. You know?
Venn diagram, that's right.
Viggo, why are you here?
I'm here because I want to become a British comedian.
Okay, right, no more questions. Good luck.
Thank you, thank you.
One more time.
Simon's face is like this.
Look at Simon's face.
In Norway, that means you're doing really good.
Oh.
Is there any more? Is there any more?
Come on, please.
Yeah.
obviously. Okay, any more?
You want more?
No. No.
I love this app so much!
stupidity to such a level that was just, it was killing me.
Oh, I thought you were going to do stand-up comedy.
Yeah, but it's a bit difficult with the language for me.
I have no idea what's going on right now, but it was really annoying, it was stupid, none of it was very good. Let's just go to the yes and no bit. Bruno.
Is a yes for me.
Oh, definitely yes.
Look, you know what? I like the music, but it is what it is, which is... the most stupid act we've had this year.
I think this feels very much Britain's Got Talent-y. So I'm going to say yes. We've got through to the next round.
It all comes down to this.
Just two acts remain, Liliana Clifton and Viggo Venn. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2023 is...
Listen, you were brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Let's hear it one more time for this year's runner-up, Liliana Clifton!
Thank you, darling. Well, would you look at that? Congratulations, Viggo Venn, you are the winner of Britain's Got Talent 2023.
I feel extremely visible right now. Thank you so much.
What would you like to say? You clearly captured to the heart of Britain. Loads of people have voted for you. What would you like to say to the people who voted for you?
Not just the heart of Britain, but the heart of Simon.
Yeah, you did. You did.
But yeah, thank you so much, everyone who voted for me. That's you want more?
This year's winner. We would like to say thank you to our fantastic judges, Bruno Tognoli, Alicia Dixon, Amanda Holden, and Simon Cowell.
Can we just say a huge thank you to every single act that turned up at Audition? Come on, judges, come and join us. We could not do the show without the acts. Thank you.
Of course, the biggest thanks goes to you at home for watching. We'll see you all again soon. But for now, your winner, Viggo Venn!
Viggo!
How are you?
I'm fine, thank
Good.
You.
Good, right, introduce me, please.
I'm Ashleigh, and this is my dog, Pudsey.
Pudsey?
Pudsey, yeah.
He's gorgeous. How old is he?
He's 6.
Okay, so tell me about the two of you. When did you first meet?
My mum gave him to me for my 11th birthday.
Okay, and how old are you?
I'm 16.
Okay, so you're at school?
Yeah.
Okay, so where do you see the two of yourself if you were to win this show in a few years' time? I'm looking for Oscars. Do you think your dog and you could win an Oscar?
Yes.
Oh, he is pricked up at that, look.
Yes.
Yeah, he's good Oscar. He's like, yeah.
Good. Best of luck.
Thank you. Pudsey. Come on, Pudsey. Good boy. Ready?
He's a cute little thing, isn't he?
Sit. Right.
Oh. I want him.
Are adorable. I've been dying to see a dancing dog. That was fantastic.
Thank you.
Well done.
Good boy.
Everything about that was brilliant. Chemistry between the two of you. I was completely blown away.
Thank you.
You know me. I love a dancing dog. I do. And Pudsey's one of the best dancing dogs I've ever seen. Great connection between the two of you. My only criticism would have been I would have put Pudsey in a prehistoric outfit as well. Do you think Pudsey would change if he won the show?
I think he could go a bit diva, maybe. A little bit. He gets what he wants.
Okay, well, we're going to have to vote now. David, yes or no?
1,000,000% yes. Loved it.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me.
Ashleigh, and more importantly, Pudsey, you're through to the next round. Three yeses.
So this is it, after thousands of auditions, five semi-finals and an incredible final, it is down to you two acts. One of you is about to walk away with £500,000 and a place at the Royal Variety Performance in front of Her Majesty the Queen. Good luck to you both.
Here we go. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2012 is...
To Jonathan and Charlotte, you came so close, but you have been amazing. Have you enjoyed it?
Oh my God, we came second.
Yeah.
Out of 70,000 people. That's incredible. It's been amazing.
You have been fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time for Jonathan and Charlotte.
Just have a chat with the winners of Britain's Got Talent, Ashleigh Pudsey. How do you feel right now?
I just want to say a massive thank you to everyone that voted me, and I'm just so proud of Pudsey, and it means so much.
You should be so proud. Can I just remind you something that you might have forgot? You've just won £500,000. Well done. Listen, well done. Will you perform with Pudsey for us one more time? Yeah. Can you do that? Go and get yourself ready then. See you in a second. Off you go. See you in a second.
Judges, what a result. What do you think of that? Simon, what a result.
My life's work is now complete. can I just quickly say, I know we're running out of time.
Yeah.
I want to say a huge thank you to these three. This has been my favourite year. To you two, who are always amazing.
Thank you.
And the contestants, and importantly, every single member of this production team who've done a brilliant job. And once again, to the British public who've supported these shows for so many years. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
My name's Axel Blake, and I'm from West London.
So, Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son. He's in the audience.
Nice.
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do, actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
Come, we're friends now.
Yeah, OK, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job, this obviously is what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%, it's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going.
Yeah.
So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise! I was going to drive here today, but I realised I don't have a licence, so... Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? Think... No, you don't. This old lady is strong. Oh, my... Have it, Margaret, have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a minus 2 at King's Cross, love. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. But on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know? Aww. Yeah, so we wanted to give her a fitting name, so we named her Pfizer, yeah? Yeah. I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good!
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed, evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I do, when I use it, beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That'll be £19.30. Boop. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off in style. Who's in a happy relationship? Make some noise. Yeah, me and my fiance have been together for years, 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 years. And my friends ask me, how do you do it? How are you together for so long? Through the pandemic, baby. And I just say, find your woman that, you know, loves you, understands your flaws, and find your woman that has a good sense of humor. Just make sure those three women don't find out about each other. That's a trick. Yeah, but we don't really have issues. In fact, I'm like, the biggest issue we have is I hate when she would imitate my voice in an argument and it sounds nothing like my voice. I can't stand it. She come up to me, I asked you what time you're coming home and you said to me, I don't know what time you're coming home. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. What I do now, I've got a way to get her back. I imitate her voice back and guess what? She don't like it. I did tell you what time I was coming home and you said, well, make sure you come back at a decent time. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. She gets angry. Get out of my face, get out of my face. I say, all right, I'll get out of your face. But how do I do it? In style.
Yay! In style!
My name's Axel Blake, thank you.
What did you think?
A comedy superstar is born tonight on that stage. So funny. You made it all seem so effortless. You've got a wonderful, so likeable personality. And everything you said was brilliantly funny and original. I loved it, Axel.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well done, Axel. Super, super, super confident. The first person, honestly, who's ever made a joke about COVID and was funny. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but, you know, after what everybody's gone through over the last couple of years, boy, A, we needed this show back on air. We needed acts like you. There's one thing I have to tell you, though. I kind of like a granite top. I like a waste disposal unit. I want 25% off, and you get this. needed you. Absolutely brilliant. Thank you.
And we're left with two. Okay. After an incredible set of auditions, five amazing semi-finals and an unforgettable final, it all comes down to this.
Just two acts remain. Jamie Leahy and Chuck and Axel Blake. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
Here we go then. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2022 is... Axel Blake! Congratulations, but a massive commiserations to Jamie Leahy. You've been Jamie. To come second in this year's final says a lot, pal. You're brilliant. You must be thrilled.
I am, yeah. It's amazing. Thanks.
What would you like to say to everybody out there who voted for you?
I'd like to say thanks for all the support and, yeah. And there's one guy in here, and his name is Lewis Devine, and he has helped me so much.
Oh, come here, you. Come here. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time for a very deserving runner-up, Jamie Leahy and Chuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner. How do you feel?
Words can't even explain. I am shaking. Thank you, everyone, for voting for me. It means the world to me. Thank you, everyone at home. I can't even, there's not even words to explain right now. I can't believe it.
Do you know, I'm thrilled that you won, but what's going to get on my goat is the fact you were Simon Cowell's golden buzzer at. Damn it! He's going to be thrilled. Well done, pal. Well done.
I don't know what to say. Apart from thank you, and in style, yeah!
Simon.
There we are, there's his son. Here comes Simon, because he loves coming on stage at the end of the show. Give him a hug, Simon.
Hello.
Hi.
We met you last year, didn't we?
Yeah.
You're taller.
I know.
Much taller.
I know.
What did you do last year? You were a dancer.
Yeah.
Right. And you didn't make it through to the live shows, did you?
Yeah, didn't make it through to the live
shows. No, I think, for me, I always thought you should have done, to be honest with you. So what have you learnt in the last 12 months?
Last 12 months, I've just trained harder and I've just got bigger and better with moves and
good
everything.
Good attitude.
So.
You've got to raise the bar a bit this year, right?
Yeah.
OK, off you go.
Come on, George.
Really want him to do well.
I do, yeah.
Okay, George, you know I'm a fan. and I seriously fought for you last year to get into the finals, and I was really disappointed you didn't. Last year, I thought you were fantastic. This year, I didn't. I thought you were phenomenal.
I've never heard that word before. Not from him, anyway.
The best dancer we have had by a clear mile.
We like people like you. You know, people who don't get quite far enough and go away, think about it and think, you know what, I'm going to prove them wrong.
Amanda.
I completely agree with Piers. Great spirit, great, lovely smile, great face, great energy. Just really cool.
Piers, yes or no?
Well, I'm a yes, obviously. Brilliant.
Amanda?
Yes!
George Sampson. Three yeses.
Absolutely fantastic, man. George and Signature, it's down to you. After 50,000 auditions, 5 semi-finals, and an incredible final, this is it. One of you is about to win £100,000 and a place at this year's Royal Variety Performance. Good luck. Quiet, please. Thank you. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2008 is... George Sampson!
Ladies and gentlemen, but what a runner-up we've had this year. Solomon, Madhu, you're the runners-up in the competition, but you didn't take anything away from what you achieved and performed.
Nothing at all. We'd just like to say thank you to everybody who supported us, family, friends, the judges, and you guys.
Thanks, guys. Solomon.
It's been a wonderful performance. It's been a wonderful show. We've had a wonderful time. And you know what? George is a worthy winner. We're massive fans of George ourselves. And congratulations, George.
Thanks, guys.
One more time for our runners-up. Signature, everybody!
George. OK, guys. Nice and quiet, please, so we can hear from the winner. Now, will you perform for us again? The guys are going to set your routine behind us. Will you do it again?
Yeah, definitely.
Good, because we're dying to see it. Listen. You are going to perform in front of Prince Charles. How do you feel, George?
Oh, I'm speechless. Wow. Just thanks so much. Everybody, just thanks so much.
George, what do you want to say to all the people out there who voted for you and put you where you are? You've become the winner of Britain's Got Talent. What do you want to say to them?
You've changed my life, and I couldn't ask for anything else. And thanks so much.
Wow. Judges, what a result.
Simon, what do you think of this?
George, let me tell you, you are the dancing version of Rocky, young man. Yeah. You deserve everything, because you battled your way to the top, and congratulations.
Well done, George.
Hello, my name is Lee, and, for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
OK, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Ant and Dec.
This is all going so well up until that point.
The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But, just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, the next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross. And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs, special schools, special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
Here we go, after thousands of auditions, five incredible semi-finals, and an amazing final, it comes down to this. Two acts remain, Robert White and Lost Voice Guy. One of you is about to win £250,000 and a place on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2018 is... Lost Voice Guy! To this year's runner-up, second place. Commiserations, Robert, but second place.
Yeah, it's amazing. This whole year was about giving up comedy and starting teaching, so this will be a lovely thing to remember comedy as I become a full-time teacher in September.
You did so brilliantly. We have loved having you here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for this year's runner-up, Mr. Robert White. Well, would you look at you? He's done it. You've only done it. What would you like to say to the judges, first of all?
I have been blown away by the support of the judges and the general public. I've got so much love from everyone, and I'm really grateful for it all.
You're going to be performing for the royal family. How do you feel about that?
I'm very excited to get to perform in front of the Queen. I've loved her since she sang Bohemian Rhapsody.
Judges, would you like to come onto the stage and join me? Come on up and congratulate our winner. Come on up, he has done it. He's made it all the way through. And you voted for him in your hundreds of thousands, our lost voice guy. Congratulations. Judges are coming up to say congratulations. Well done, but that is it. Lost Voice Guy is this year's winner. I'd like to say a huge thank you to our judges. One sec. David Williams, Alicia Dixon, Amanda Holland, and Simon Cowell.
I want to say to you, Deck, you have done an outstanding job this week. Seriously, thank you. And to you, you have so deserved this. I am so happy. Back to you, Deck.
I've got 5 seconds to say basically thank you to everybody. Thank you to you for watching. That is it from us. We'll see you on ITV2 with Stephen. Good night, everybody.
Every champion once was a contender that refused to give up. Now we're back.
Flatly and Twist and Pulse. You are the two acts with the most votes, but only one of you can leave here as our ultimate champion.
Good luck to the both of you. The winner of Britain's Got Talent, the Champions 2019,
I don't know,
is...
you know, it's 50-50, man. twist and pulls.
Guys, well, let me have a chat with our winners very briefly before we talk to Stavros Flatley. Twist and Pulse, you are the Britain's Got Talent champions. How do you feel?
I am absolutely speechless. I can't thank you guys enough. Like, I'm holding back everything right now. Yeah, literally feel like amazing, man. Like literally. I've said it before, things like this don't happen to me and my best friend Glenn, so I would just like to say thank you so much. This means the world to us, honestly.
You're winners.
Well done, boys. Guys, we have to say a huge congratulations and well done. Second place, how do you feel?
Unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable. And I just want to say thank you for everything over the last 10 years. And thank you, Dad, for everything you've done for me, honestly. Thank you so much.
We have loved having you back. I can safely say BGT The Champions 2019 would not have been the same without Stavros Flatley. Thank you so much again for being here. One more time, let's hear it for them. Stavros Flatley! Boys, come here. You've done it. You've gone one step further. You're no longer runners-up. You're the winners.
I literally cannot believe it.
Look what else we've found. It's time to hand over your trophy and saying congratulations for being our ultimate champions. Boys, here's your trophy. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for the winners of Britain's Got Talent, the Champions 2019. Twist and Pulse!
Spent a lifetime stuck in silence, afraid you'll say something.
So we are left with Attraction, Richard and Adam and Jack Carroll. Guys, in no particular order, you were voted the top three acts by the public, but only one of you is our winner.
We're going to start by announcing the act in third place. Here goes. The third placed act in Britain's Got Talent 2013 is... Richard and Adam. Gents, you've done brilliantly tonight. Congratulations. Third place is yours this year. Let's hear it one more time for Richard and Adam.
Okay, guys, we're just going to squeeze in here a second. We can get in the middle. Thank you. Right then, this is it. This is it. There were thousands of auditions. Five semi-finals and an unforgettable final. And now it's down to you two acts. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2013 is...
Well done, girl. Congratulations. We'll let you compose yourself for a second. Well done.
What do you do? We just want to have a word with this year's runner-up, Jack Carroll, everybody. So close. How do you feel right now?
Runner up. A little bit insensitive, is it not? yeah, but I've had a great time and, you know, it's to come second. Cheers, everyone.
Jack, for a comedian and a 14-year-old comedian to come runner up in this competition is some feat. You've done brilliantly.
I've tried my best and, you know, fair enough. Cheers to everyone who voted.
You've been brilliant. Let's hear it one more time for this year's runner-up, Jack Carroll, everybody.
Well done, Jack. And let's congratulate the winners, Attraction.
He's got to shoot straight off to catch a train.
Hi, guys. And who are you?
We're Diversity.
Okay. And who's Diversity? What is Diversity?
We're a street dance group.
Who put the group together?
Group's made up of three sets of brothers and friends. So, I mean, like, we've just known each other for absolutely
What about the little one?
Oh, no, this is, you know, he hasn't got a brother, but he's... He's cute.
And what are the chances of you guys winning this? Good?
Good. We'd like to think so.
Okay. Well, look, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Good luck.
Thank you.
Where are you going? Is that you done?
No, I've got...
You're going back on. Do you want me to take that?
Finish for that.
Thank you. There you are.
Yeah. I have a dream.
You are free.
Amanda.
It's just, this show is just so brilliant, because just when I think I've seen it all and nothing could get any better, you came on. Honestly, the connection between you, because you've kind of got this relationship, I can see straight away. It was dynamic, it was funny, it was imaginative, superb, honestly. I love it.
Choreograph that. You did.
Genius!
I thought that was incredibly creative. I mean, very, very inspired. And we've had a lot of dance acts this year, and we thought the talent bar on that was very high. You are right up there with the best of the dancers we've seen. What do you guys do? I mean, I'm presuming you two are probably still at school, but the others, are you working, are you students?
I'm personally at university studying physics. Terry's just graduated with a master's. One of the guys is a telecom engineer, bathroom installation, Ian's IT solutions. We're just normal guys.
What I just saw today was so inventive, so current, but it kind of feels like a second wave of something, something I've never seen before. I've never seen dance so imaginative, so creative, so entertaining. Okay, here's yes or no.
Absolutely loved it. I'm a yes.
Amanda?
Guess what? I'm a yes.
Diversity, you've got three huge yeses.
So, Susan, diversity, this is it. It's down to the two of you after five dramatic semi-finals and an amazing final tonight. This is it. One of you is about to win £100,000 and that place on the bill at this year's Royal Variety Performance. Good luck to both of you. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2009 is... Diversity! Diversity obviously means a lot, but with every winner there has to be a runner-up, and this year it is Susan Ball. What a fantastic competitor. Susan, how do you feel right now?
The best people won.
That's very gracious of you. You said to me there you came runner-up to very deserved winners. Do you feel that?
I really do. They're very entertaining. Lads, I wish you all the best.
Oh, that's very, very gracious. Susan, can I just say, on behalf of us all here at Britain's Got Talent, it has been amazing to meet you. Thank you so much for taking part. We've all shared an incredible journey with you over the last 7 weeks. You've been phenomenal. One more time, let's hear it for the runner-up, Susan Boyle!
Say, Congratulations, diversity. Well done. Nice and quiet, please. I'd like to speak to the winners. Guys, you've just won Britain's Got Talent. How do you feel?
You know, I was going to the guys, second. Yeah. When you said our name, honestly, I'm going to wake up in a minute.
That's well, look, you're going to perform for the Queen. Oh. You guys are going to be there.
Can I just thank everyone that voted? You changed our lives, and I can't actually believe. Thank you for this.
You're welcome.
Hello, welcome. What's your name, please?
My name's Jai.
Where are you from, Jai?
I'm from Scotland.
Scotland.
Yeah.
What are you doing for a living currently, Jai?
At the moment, I work as a support worker.
Okay, very good. This is your big moment. Very best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Come on, Jai. Yes.
And powerful and emotional, and three quarters of the way into it, I could see you sort of trembling and welling up, and then you belted that last bit out with everything you had. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Oh, Jai, your little knees were trembling throughout that. Your voice is so powerful. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely nailed it. You've got heart, emotion, and you know, you can let go of the microphone, man. Relax, you did it.
Okay, let's vote on it, Jai. David.
Yes.
Amanda.
I'm proud to say yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Jai. It's three yeses. Many congratulations.
So, this is it. thousands of acts auditioned, 41 made it to the semi-finals, and now, after an incredible final, it's down to you two. One of you is about to walk away with £100,000 and a place at this year's Royal Variety Performance. The very best of luck.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2011 is...
Enjoyed your time here.
I've loved it. I'd like to say thank you to everyone who voted. Thank you so much.
Listen, do you know what? Your experience has been just fantastic on this. You're not perfect tonight. We've loved having you here, and I reckon we're going to see a lot more of this little man. Yeah?
Congratulations, Jai, as well.
Look at that. What a lovely lad. Come here. Come here. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time.
So, Jai, the winner of Britain's Got Talent, how do you feel?
Absolutely amazing.
It's like
absolutely
a moment you dreamed of,
fantastic.
Huh?
Fantastic. It's so much more. Absolutely so much more.
You're going to perform for the Queen.
I know.
Will you amazing?
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well, thanks. A bit nervous.
That's all good. Right, what's your name?
My name is Tokio.
Tokio.
Yeah.
Very nice. And where are you from?
I'm from London.
Yeah, and how old are you?
I'm 32.
I'm kind of nervous, you know.
What would it mean to you to win a show like Britain's Got Talent?
It would mean the world to me, just from my background and everything that I've kind of been up to this day. I grew up in a really rough estate in London's northwest. That definitely played a role in, you know, sticking at music. It was just a way of just releasing any kind of negative energy and putting it into something positive.
Well, this is your moment. Good luck.
Thank you.
proper talented man.
Thank you.
David.
Well, you had us from the first moment. You know, you could have heard a pin drop in here. It was really, really fantastic.
Thank you very much.
It was literally like a film score. It just inspired my imagination when I was listening to it.
Oh, thank you.
Absolutely beautiful.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You're really edgy and really refreshing, and that couldn't have gone any more brilliantly.
Oh,
so well done.
Tokyo, what was the song?
So the first piece was Debussy, called Claire de Lune, and then it blended into Ed Sheeran, Bloodstream.
Very clever. We've never really had an act like you on this show before. And was there someone who was like your mentor or who inspired you?
Yeah, Mr. Morgan, he was the guy who I kind of looked up to as a kid. You know, he's my music teacher.
Yeah.
And if it wasn't for him guiding me and showing me where I could go, I probably wouldn't be here or doing what I'm doing today. So, yeah.
I absolutely love that audition.
Thank you.
Say goodbye, David.
It's a yes from me.
Amanda?
Oh, yeah, without doubt. A yes from me.
Thank you, darling.
It's a yes from me, too. Simon? 100%,
Sophia, you got 4 yeses.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me.
Here we go. We have had thousands of auditions, 5 stunning semi-finals, and an outstanding final, and it all comes down to these 2 acts.
Just 2 acts remain. Tokio Myers and Izzy, definitely Izzy Simpson. One of you is about to win £250,000 and a place on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
Here we go. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2017 is... Tokyo Myers! Well done, Tokyo! Congratulations. Oh, look at that! Look at that! Come here, you two. Izzy, come here, let's have a chat with you. Because, honestly, you came on the show. You've blown us all away. We've loved having you. Have you enjoyed it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
One more time. Let's give part of the judges. Part of the judges. There you are. Thank you very much. Each and every one of you. Thank you. One more time. I'm sure it's not the last time we'll be hearing from Izzy Simpson, everybody.
Tokyo.
What the heck? What's going on? What is going on?
Oh, my You've God. Just won the show.
I can't believe what just happened. Thank you!
Mine, me on this star, like yours, white.
So you work at Carphone Warehouse. And you did that. I wasn't expecting that.
No, neither was I.
This was a complete breath of fresh air. I thought you were absolutely fantastic.
You have an incredible voice. I think if you keep singing like that, you are going to be one of the favourites to win this whole competition.
I think that we've got a case of a little lump of coal here that is going to turn into a diamond.
OK.
Moment of truth, young man. Piers.
Absolutely yes.
Amanda?
Yes.
Paul, you are through to the next round. Don't wanna close my eyes. I don't wanna fall asleep, cause I miss you, babe. And I don't wanna miss. Congratulations.
Unbelievable. I had those pimples.
This is the moment we've all been waiting for. I can reveal we've had 2 million votes. And the results are now in.
The Combat Breakers. Simon said you were exactly what he was looking for when he started this show, and Amanda thinks you're on the road to win.
Damon Scott. Simon described you as unique and different. Piers thought you were original, incredible, and the dark horse to win.
Bessie Kersons, Amanda said she'd pay to see you in the West End, and Piers described you as the most naturally talented performer in the whole competition.
The Bar Wizards, Piers thought you were fun and entertaining. Simon loved your energy and enthusiasm and thinks you have a real chance.
Connie Talbot, Amanda said you had the sweetest voice and are super talented, and Piers thinks it will take something special tonight to beat you.
And Paul Potts, Amanda said you won't be going back to the day job. Simon described you as a shy, humble guy with a great talent.
But only one of you can win Britain's Got Talent.
Only one of you can appear at the Royal Variety Performance in front of the Queen.
And this is it. The winner of Britain's Got Talent is...
Would you like to say something to all the millions of people out there who voted for you?
Out there at home.
Just thank you for believing in me. It's just absolutely bonkers.
Well done, Paul.
Judges, what a result. Piers, is there anything you'd like to say?
I just want to say, Paul, you've earned it, you deserve it, and I can't think of anybody that I would rather see represent this show in front of Her Majesty the Queen than Paul Potts.
Deserved it. You're perfect. God, well done, and good luck with the rest of your life. It's going to be fabulous.
Excuse me, Simon.
I just want to take the time to thank you guys, the great British public, for the producers for making the best show I've ever been on. And Paul, not only I am so proud of you, and I want to say something very quickly. Next week, you are going to be in a recording studio making your debut album.
Good evening. What's your name, sir?
My name is Jon Courtenay.
Where are you from?
I live in a village called Mosley, which is near Manchester.
Oh, okay. Have you brought anyone with you?
I've got my wife and two boys, I hear.
Brilliant. How long have you played the piano?
Since I was about five, I guess.
And is that how you make a living?
Yeah.
So is this the biggest venue you've performed in?
Yeah. The Palladium is like the Holy Grail to me. I used to watch the shows with my dad, and this is the home of variety.
Oh.
Overwhelming. It's amazing.
Oh, he's so happy.
Good luck, John.
Thank you. This is bonkers.
There was a man who had a dream that Simon Cowell and his team would watch him play piano and try to slay them on the stage of the Palladium. And in the time that one song took, David would write another book. Alicia would smile at him. Amanda would be kind to him. Simon's teeth would be blinding him if he was smiling. But nothing now could ever spoil the dream he dreamed like Susan Boyle.
I like this already. Yes, John.
Let's see if we haven't been in it yet.
Fact is, he never thought he'd ever get to be in front of millions of people doing his thing on TV. 30 years of playing in piano bars and pubs, dodging glasses when they're thrown, being thrown out of clubs. When your children ask, Daddy, when you're coming home, this game is not the same when you're just Daddy on the phone. So he sits at the piano and he tries to get prepared, thinking he'll write it in third person so he doesn't feel as scared to sing about himself to a bunch of strangers in the dark. But then Britain has got talent and he wants to make his mark. Paul Potts won the first year and said it was insane. The second year, George Sampson won, singing in the rain. Lost Voice Guys season 12, and last year, Colin Thackery. So why not me?
Why not you?
That's what he said. His youngest boy, one night in bed. Dad, why not you? Go and show them what you do. And even though you'll be a wreck, at least you'll meet Anton there.
We're in it!
And he thinks on stage, at this stage in his life, with an expensive mortgage and a pensive wife. His youngest son, Alfie, says, what's it all about? If he had any hair left, he'd pull it out. His teenage son said, His dad taught him to play piano, but he didn't live to see his son at the famous theatre performing on TV. If he didn't see it through, imagine how sad the look on the faces of both his lads, who always tell him, you're the greatest showman, Dad. They'll see me on BGT, no more third person, just Daddy, this is me.
Fault a bit, I don't know why. I just saw a man who kind of made all his dreams come true.
It really was, yeah.
David.
It was just so winning, wasn't it? Yeah. I mean, my goodness me, it made the whole audience, and I'm sure everyone watching at home, just fall in love with him.
I love him.
He had everything, and at the end, he had us moved to tears. This show is perfect for you, and now I want to see you go as far as you can in this competition.
Wow.
Well done.
John, it was just a wonderful audition. You're somebody who's worked for years, needs a break. You'll get a huge reaction of this, I promise you. And we all want you to do well. So I would love to be the first to say yes.
You deserve it. You deserve it. Here's the other son. Here he comes.
Well, here we are, after thousands of auditions, five amazing semi-finals, and a year unlike any other, we are now left with just two acts.
Jon Courtenay, sign along with us. One of you is about to win £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2020 is... Jon Courtenay!
Jon, congratulations! Quickly, how do you feel?
Oh, don't make me speak. look at me!
Look, we'll come back to you in a moment.
Take a minute.
Take a moment.
Okay.
Take a moment.
Listen. Jade, Christian, congratulations and commiserations. Oh, second place this year, runners-up on Britain's Got Talent, but what an achievement. You must be so proud.
So proud of every single one of the group. I'm shaking, I can't believe it. Well done. So deserved.
Very kind of you.
Jade, you're an incredible young lady. What you've done is amazing with this group of people. We salute you and thank you for coming to be with us at Britain's Got Talent 2020. Well done, Christian.
Thank you.
Big kisses
so
to you.
Well done.
Along with us.
Oh, but let's just turn back to the winner of Britain's Got Talent and the first ever golden buzzer winner of Britain's Got Talent, Jon Courtenay, and he's our golden buzzer. Yes! Oh, I want to hug you so much. Jon, how'd you feel? How'd you feel?
I just, I've tried not to think about it. Because I'm really bad at hiding disappointment. A couple of mornings I've woken up, and actually this morning, for the first time, this sounds really dramatic, but I woke up, sometimes I have an idea for a song, and I literally woke up with an idea for a song for the Royal Variety Performance.
Oh, wow.
And I woke up and went, oh my, and I wrote it down, and I tried not to think of that as being a sign, because as I say, it would have been too much pressure. Just amazing. I can't actually believe that I'm still...
Well done. Congratulations. You deserve a real winner there, judges, isn't that right? Absolutely fantastic.
Well done, John.
So anything
well
you'd like to say to the people who voted for you and the judges?
Very quickly,
okay, John.
Listen, thank you. You don't know how much this means. It's changed my life, my family's life. My mum, I can't imagine how you're coping right now. I hope you're still alive.
John, that's all the time we've got. John Courtenay.
Hi there.
And who are you all, please?
We are Spelbound.
And gymnastics?
It is, yes.
OK, and tell me the age range here.
We're going from 12 to 24.
I'm sorry, I can't believe you're set. You're, how old are you?
18.
18?
Yep, yeah.
OK. I can believe that six-pack now. It's just unbelievable. And tell me, what's the dream here?
The dream is impress you guys, impress the audience, and go into the Royal Variety Good. Performance.
Good. Best of luck, guys.
Thank you.
Say, I have never seen anything like that in my life. I thought, you know, once again we were going to get some really boring gymnastics display, but it was very clever, really, really smart.
It was absolutely faultless. That some of the stuff that was going on, I didn't think was humanly possible. Outstanding.
The pace of it got bigger and bigger as it went on. The momentum built, the drama built, the story was great, and in the end it reached this thrilling conclusion that had the whole theatre going crazy.
OK, we're going to vote. Here's yes or no?
Absolute yes from me.
Amanda?
It's a yes from me.
Got it. This is very simple. You've got three yeses. Well done.
Absolutely incredible. Incredible.
So, Twist and Pulse. And Spellbound. It's down to you. After tens of thousands of auditions, five semi-finals, and an amazing final, this This is it. One of you is about to walk away with £100,000 and a place at this year's Royal Variety Performance. The very best of luck. The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2010 is... Imagination out there, and I'm sure this is not the last time we've seen you.
No. I just gotta say thank you everyone for voting our second out of all those people that auditioned. Is absolutely amazing. Honestly, yeah. Thank you.
Well done, guys. Listen, we've got to set the stage for Spellbound now. Give them a big hand. Twist and Pulse, thanks, guys. What's happening is we're just going to set the floor because we'd love to see these guys perform again.
We'll come on over.
Yes, we will, but come over. Before that, we're going to have a chat with you.
We've got to say, first of all, congratulations. you've done it. From all those thousands of acts that have auditioned, you've made it. You're number one with the public. You're the winners. How do you feel?
Oh, my God, this is unbelievable. We just want to say thank you to everyone out there. It just shows that all our hard work has paid off. Neil, can you...
This is Neil, the coach. Come on in, Neil.
Neil, I've got to ask you. Neil, come here. I've got to
Let's have a quick word with you.
You're a slave driver, we know that. but you put this routine together, you work these guys hard. How proud of you are you of them right now?
Oh, they've worked so hard over the last few weeks. Since the semi-final, we really had to pull out the stops to try and up the game. They've not moaned, they've worked in the gym from 6 of the morning till 12 o'clock of an hour. I couldn't have asked for more. And it's a team of coaches, I don't take all the credit myself. There's two people up there that know who they are who have been fantastic.
Guys, you've had us spellbound from the first moment we saw you in the auditions. I know the judges loved it tonight. Simon, what worthy winners?
Do you know what? The show is called Britain's Got Talent. Absolutely the right guys and girls won on the night. I am very proud of you all. Well done.
Has this been a dream of yours all your life?
It has. It's always been a dream to perform on the Royal Variety Show.
Sure.
And meet the Queen in person, so.
She's very nice. She's very nice. Very easy to chat to. And when you go over for dinner, she's just very normal and down to earth.
Okay, well, listen, Richard, I really wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much. Do you mind if I join you on
Please.
The table?
I would like that.
Thank you very much.
I'm going to sit here and watch on the screen. Want a cup of tea? I love stuff like this.
Now, I have a gift here. This is a gift which is going to be for one of you judges in just a few moments, but I'm going to leave it there for now. I also have two notebooks. On each of these notebooks, I have different things written. One is for you, Amanda.
Right.
As I flick through, would you mind reading some of these out for me?
Jennifer Aniston, Madonna, Brad Pitt, Taylor Swift, Vin Diesel, Halle Berry, Emma Stone, Tom Hanks.
They're all celebrities, 60 celebrities to be precise. If you could hold your hand flat for me, place your other hand directly on top and just hold it there. I also have one for you, David.
Oh.
This one here is a drinks menu. On every page is a different drink. Please read some out for us.
Cola, Fanta, Mojito.
Vodka, rum, whiskey. I'm right now. I'm just...
If you could hold your hand flat and place your other hand on top. Now, just with your thumb, lift up, make sure no one sees, and just take a peek at whatever you choose, and then slam it closed for me. And please, could you stand up and just throw them onto the stage, because we no longer need those. Unleash the anger. Perfect.
Good throw, David.
OK, Amanda, we're going to start with yourself. You're thinking of a celebrity, is that correct?
Yes.
Thinking of a celebrity. Just stand up for me. What I need you to do is send the thoughts straight directly into my mind. I need you just with your finger, look me directly in the eye and just touch me just on the forehead there. Felt that, right?
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Oh,
now,
goodness.
What you've just done is you've just directly sent your thoughts into my mind, and I'm now going to very creatively find out who you are thinking of. Now, believe it or not, before I became a magician, I spent 6 years in an origami intensive training center in the heart of Japan, just so I could be here with you guys doing this right now. Now, am I right in saying this is someone who's very particular about their hair?
Yes.
And I think it's probably a man. Don't give anything away, but I'm going to just... Perfect. Okay, Amanda, please tell us, this wonderful audience, who are you thinking of?
David Beckham.
David Beckham. If I open this up, I've made something very, very special for you to keep. We have Mr. Still thinking of a drink, is that correct?
Correct.
Would you mind now revealing to us the drink that you have been thinking of?
It's the drink I'm drinking right now.
Which is?
A cup of tea.
A cup of tea?
A cup of tea.
Now, this has been here the whole time. It's been in front of yourself, Simon.
Yeah.
Inside here, ladies and gentlemen, just as you asked for, orange soda. A little bit awkward, but we can still fix this. Don't panic. Could you just reach out your hand just here for me? Just send me that positive energy.
Oh! What is going on?
Wow.
I didn't like it.
So rude. Oh my goodness.
Believe it or not, you've now just filled me with all of your kinetic energy, which allows me to act almost like a microwave, so the can starts to heat up.
Oh, come on.
And it gets hotter and hotter. Please feel it.
What?
Feel the can. It's getting hotter and hotter. Yeah, just make sure that is a sealed can. I asked you to think of one drink, you said breakfast tea, was that right?
Correct.
If I open this up, ladies and gentlemen, just what you ordered.
No way.
Tea.
Tea in a can.
Please taste it.
It's a proper cup of tea.
Please taste it, make sure it really is tea.
A delicious cup of tea.
It is tea, thank you very much. Thank you.
How the hell did you do that?
I have no idea.
Thank you so much.
Good luck. Good luck.
After thousands of auditions, five dramatic semi-finals and a phenomenal final, this is it.
Just two acts remain. Richard Jones. Wayne Woodworth. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a place on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2016 is... Richard Jones!
Take a bow, sunshine. Take a bow, you deserve it. Well done. How do you feel?
It's unbelievable. Thank you so much.
Listen, we've come here now.
We just want to talk runner-up this year.
Thank you so much. It's been just an absolutely amazing experience, and I've met so many amazing people. And whether I came here tonight or not, you know, I've had a lovely time. So thank you so much for having me, and I hope to see a lot more of you, and I hope you see a lot more of me.
I don't think that's the last we're going to see of Wayne Woodward. Ladies and gentlemen, our runner-up in 2016, Wayne Woodward!
love it. Richard, you are the winner of Britain's Got Talent 2060. Can you believe it?
I can't believe it. Thank you so much to everyone who voted. It's an incredible feeling. I want to thank my family. I want to thank Fergus. I want to thank the Magic Circle and the whole community, Prop Dog, everyone's done it. They've been absolutely fantastic. Everyone's been so supportive. Thank you to everyone here and everyone at home watching. It means the world to me.
Listen, you're a worthy winner. One more time, the winner of Britain's Got Talent, Richard Jones!
Actually know each other. Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. For those of us who haven't already met you, can you introduce yourself?
My name is Colin Thackery. I'm 88. And as you can see, I'm a Chelsea pensioner. I'm going to sing you a song that is dedicated actually to my late wife.
Colin, I think it's extraordinary you've come here. The stage is yours.
Thank you very much.
It must have been cold there in my shadow. To never see sunlight on your face. You did your best to make me shine. You always walked a step behind. I was the one with all the glory. Why, you were the one with all the strength. Beautiful face without a name. I never once heard you complain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything that I'd like to be. I could fly higher than an eagle. Cause you are the wind beneath my wings. It might have appeared to go unnoticed, but I have it all here in my heart. I want you to know, I know the truth. I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything that I'd like to be. I could fly higher than an eagle. You are the wind beneath.
Just to know how it feels.
comes Colin.
Well, Colin, there is not a dry eye in the house.
Thank you.
Well, it was just the most perfect tribute, and you sung with such heart that it affected all of us deeply. It was beautiful.
Oh, Colin, I really, really loved that. You show to everyone it's never too late to do the things you love and to sing about the people that you love. That was wonderful.
As I was listening to the words, I've never thought of it before, thinking that all of the men and women that fought for their country are the wind beneath our wings, because if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here. Congratulations, it was a lovely tribute.
You are going to have a moment, and it was sincere and it was real, and you are what the show is all about, so thank you. Let's start with David.
I'm going to kick this off with a very easy yes.
It's a yes from me, Colin.
And from me.
Got four yeses. Now the day bleeds
into nightfall. We've had thousands of auditions, five amazing semi-finals and an outstanding final, and now it all comes down to this.
Just two acts remain, Colin Thackery and X. One of you is about to leave here with £250,000 and a spot on the bill at the Royal Variety Performance.
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2019 is...